coordinate system. Otherwise, it is called as partition coordinate system. So, if you are taking one-dimensional system, just taking the text or vector, these are examples for one-dimensional things. Two-dimensional, it is one kind of extended dimension. So, image is represented in a partition coordinate system or plane, in a plane. Generally, it is represented by means of the intensity level. That is called as f of x, y. you came up image that, that maybe we need second pages of camera, or that maybe second pages of an X-ray machine, or any kind of imaging system. So the fundamental steps in this digital image processing is these things. Color image processing, image restoration, image filtering and enhancement, image acquisition, multi-resolution processing, compression, and then morphological processing, segmentation, presentation description, object recognition. These are the important steps used in this image processing. Otherwise, we can say that these are the various phases of image processing. Nowadays, this automation plays a vital role in color image processing. Slightly, know what are the various image processing algorithms used in these phases. Usually, the grayscale images are done for processing. Just if you want to work with image processing things, you usually take the grayscale image. Otherwise, it is called as the intensity image processing with intensity level from 0 to 2. Just if you are seeing black and white television, the images generated by this black and white television, it is not a black and white image. It is a grayscale image. Wrongly, we are telling the television as a black and white television and color television. That's why color television, from these three basic colors, the various colors are generated. But in black and white television, the images are not black and white. That is grayscale images. Black and white images means only the pixels are represented by means of two levels. That is 0 level, another means 1 level. 0 means by means of intensity value 0, or 1 means by means of highest intensity value 255. The image is approximate by means of these two values. That is called the black and white image processing. Generally, the black and white images are not concept of this image processing. Usually, the grayscale images are taken. Based on the passing of this grayscale images, next to the color images are processed. So color image processing, that is color image processing, every pixel is represented by three values, red, green and blue. Two kinds of arrays are used for processing this color image. Next, another is image restoration. Image restoration means enhancing the image quality to a certain level. Otherwise, restoration can be pronounced as restoration. So, image restoration. So, image is very blurred. So, that image is converted into its original form. It is restoration. Various algorithms available to improve the quality of the image. So this come under this image restoration. Next, image filtering and enhancement. This image filtering means unwanted pixel values are removed from the image by means of a filter. So what is called as a filter, copy filter? It is used to remove copy powder or some dust from copy. That is a copy filter. Similarly, the image contains various kinds of noises. These noises are removed by means of image filtering algorithm. Based on the filtering algorithm, the image is enhanced. Next one is image acquisition. So, image acquisition means capturing image by means of various devices. Already we saw various types of images. Generally, the camera, digital camera that is used for capturing images, but X-ray images and MRI images, these are various types of images. Image acquisition is the process of capturing image by means of image capturing system. Next, to attain the fine quality of the image, the image is to be processed. Otherwise, it is called for a detailed representation of the image, the image is to be processed. Next one is wavelength multi-resolution processing. Generally, the image is represented in time domain representation. Whenever we are talking about the images, images are processed in two forms. One is time domain representation, another one is frequency domain representation. Just if you want to do some work regarding this image processing, you can do it in a time domain form or frequency domain. So, you know that what is time domain representation and what is frequency domain representation. Time domain representation means the images are captured by means of camera. Those are stored on system. Then those images are directly processed by some image processor. It is a time domain representation. Next one is the frequency domain representation. Now, the images are converted into some other form. Just you may already studied the subjects like the Fourier transform, Wavelet transform, Walz transform. These are the various kinds of transforms. I think what is the use of transform? Just Fourier transform means there exists inverse Fourier transform also. Okay? It is a part of signal processing. Why this Fourier transform is important for image processing is, it is also important for digital signal processing. Just one can convert the value from one domain to another domain. Next, if you apply this inverse Fourier transform, then original image is obtained. It is the purpose of transforming the image. Why this transforming from one domain to another domain is required? Some kind of images are processed in frequency spectrum, then time domain representation. Okay, already we talked about two domains, time domain and another domain is frequency domain. This frequency domain representation gives more accurate than time domain representation. Then only the images are to be converted from time domain representation to frequency domain representation. And for converting the image from time domain to frequency domain, the Fourier transform is the Fourier method. Similarly, some other methods exist to convert this from time domain to frequency domain. And just if you apply the inverse transform on this converted image from time domain to frequency domain, inverse transform generates the original image, that is the beauty of the transform. In order to process the image for accurate, more accurate, this conversion from time domain to frequency domain is required. Here, wavelength processing, it is one of frequency domain representation of image, and processing in this frequency domain. Just if you are talking about the filtering of an image, just if you are going to the root image, and fine learning, if you take photos, then this cube and any rain appears, that is also stored as a part of images. Generally, according to this image processing point of view, this cube or rain
These are called as the noises. ECD, these noises can be removed from the image. So, generally the noises, simple noise like water drop present in the image, these are called as saltant peppermints. So, the saltant peppermints is removed by means of some kind of filter. This sodium filter plays an important role to remove this saltant peppermints. Various filters are designed. It is the part of the image represented in a kind of a representation. Directly apply some filtering algorithm to remove the noises present in this image. Otherwise, this image, the same image, can be converted into frequency domain representation by means of any kind of transform. Then the noises can be represented in frequency domain also. So, in time domain representation, various filtering algorithms are used. In frequency domain representation also, the various filtering algorithms exist. All these algorithms are used to improve the quality of the image. Next is the compression. The another one technology in this image process is the image compression. So nowadays this MPEG 4, it is one of compression method. Generally it is compression used to reduce the size of the image. So nowadays 3 or 4 films stored on one CD. It is achieved by means of image compression method, just to reduce the size of the pixel to some level. Revolution encoding, that is a kind of compression method, which is a very basic compression method. Next one is morphological processing. It is another kind of processing. Generally, this morphological processing is applied on this basic image. It is increasing the size of image and reducing the size of image to a certain level without affecting the quality of image. The image can be size can be reduced or enhanced. So it is achieved by means of dilation and the erosion property of this morphological image processing algorithms. Next one is the segmentation. It is dividing one image file into various parts. For example, a photograph is taken. In this photograph, one elephant, background is a forest, and the dates water from a river. In this photograph, in this segmentation algorithm, used to group some similar features. Elephant is segmented. Similarly, this background forest that is segmented, that is separated into individually. Next to this water, river, that is segmented, that is separated from this image. This process is called the segmentation. That means individual objects are segmented into the same one thing. It is done by means of various segmentation algorithms. Next, this representation and description. For example, nowadays various algorithms used to represent the image. Just if you give the photograph of this algorithm, that can identify the picture along with the photograph. For example, a rose flower is present means rose, the word rose is written on the flower. Similarly, if a dark picture appear in your image means the dark, the word dark is written on this dark image. So similarly, the various algorithms exist in this image. image processing. Next one is the object recognition. And other is the robot uses this object recognition algorithm. If a robot is running in a street or running in a home, any obstacle appears in front of this means, this one will, the obstacle is captured by a camera, and the robot should avoid the path otherwise it will destroy the obstacle, or the robot lift that will be destroyed. So it uses this object recognition technique. Similarly, the human image is captured, and by means of this object recognition method, the eye and nose mouth, these are separated from this human human face. So in these problems, various domains, the image processing algorithms are applied. According to me nowadays, this object recognition plays important role in this image processing, and also the segmentation, compression, these are the important algorithms are to be developed by means of image processing methods. So finally, all these are linked to the knowledge base. Actually, this knowledge base, it is similar to the database, but database and knowledge base, some difference exists. Human brain, it is a knowledge base. RDBMS storage is a database. So the learning algorithm along with the AI technique that forms the knowledge base. Nowadays, generally the cement processing uses AI algorithms, specifically the learning algorithms for object recognition and their segmentation, these lenses. So these are the various domains in which the image processing is applied. Here some examples are displayed as a part of various cases. Nowadays, image types, binary image, grayscale image, color image, video image. Just if you have an image type means, here you don't think it as a JPEG image, a BMP image, that is also an image type. These are various classification of images. Binary image, grayscale image, color image, and video image. Binary image actually are the black and white images. And the grayscale image, if pixel is represented from intensity value 0 to 255, then the image is called as a grayscale image. Generally, the black and white resolution, we are seeing the image as a grayscale image, not as a binary image. Color image, the image is generated in color television, that is color image. But generally, the color image is having this X and Y direction only. But video image, in addition to this X and Y direction, time is added, means that is called as video image. There is no much difference between this color image and the video image. I think you know the Q2I is having the property called as a persistence. Every image falling on this Q2I will be persistent for a few seconds. For example, if you are seeing 25 to 30 frames per second, well, frame is the individual piece of image, then we are able to get a moving image. Okay? So, 25 frames per second, that is just the video of image. So video processing also need the knowledge of image processing. This video processing algorithm is a part of image processing also. So these are the various classification image. The here it is termed as type. It is color image and the representation of color image and how to perform this color image task. So just in the left side you are seeing one color image. The color image is represented by means of
சொல்லுப்பா சொல்லுப்பா இல்ல அது அப்புறம் பார்த்துக்கலாம் நான் சொல்றேன் நான் சொல்றேன் ஆ ரைட் ஆ ரைட் அதில் வந்து அந்த இமேஜ் வந்து காப்பி பண்ணி அதில் பேஸ்ட் பண்ண நான் எப்படி நான் சொல்கிறேன் நான் ஓகே
directly we cannot process the pixel. For example, if two photographs are compared means, for example, we will take the example of Arthrad crossing. Usually for Arthrad crossing, the thumb impression and the retina image are used for this Arthrad crossing. Consider the thumb impression. So thumb impression means just now if you are placing a thumb on the resolution device means next the same thumb is placed on another device means data pixel by pixel comparison is not performed. Similarly in other part the retina image is taken. Internally, the retina image represents the thing itself. Otherwise, you can take example as a human photo. So, if you are taking the two photos means, if you do the pixel by pixel comparison between the two photo means, the two exact photo only results in positive. Otherwise, two similar photo. Just if you take the photo inside room, if you are taking the photo outside room means, in outside room in daytime, the light intensity will be more. Inside room, the sunlight intensity will be less. So, if you take the pixel by pixel comparison between these two photo means, definitely these two photos does not match because the intensity level that change. So, the pixel by pixel comparison definitely should not produce the correct result. So, in order to process this kind of image, the futures of the image is to be taken. Futures are the values. Okay? The futures are the values. Generally, the invariant futures are taken. Actually, variant future is available and invariant future is also available. So, just I am telling you an example. If you are taking I, in this I image, in the human face, it is easy to extract a human I by means of a segmentation algorithm from the photograph. Easily, the I can be separated. Otherwise, most human nose can be separated by means of some segmentation algorithm. Just easily you can find the type of width ratio of I or distance between the two I is easily taken. Similarly, if you are taking the nose, the type width ratio of the nose can be found by means of one digital image. By means of some event processing algorithm. So, distance between the eye and weight to height ratio, width to height ratio of the nose, it is invariant to the particular image, because just one see the large size of the gap and the underground picture is smaller in size, this ratio should not differ. But there is certain picture comparison where definitely the difference will exist. If you are taking the human height as for the consideration, the width to height ratio of human width that does not change for maximum size of the photograph and the minimum size of the photograph. This ratio should be the same. So, for processing the digital images, such a kind of features first should be selected, or that is to be identified. The futures are the values. These values are stored in some one-dimensional vector. Then, the image processing algorithm will process this one-dimensional vector, and based on the processing, it should generate some result. So, this is one form of processing the digital images. So here, various kinds of images are shown. Already I told about red, green and blue. These are the images. Red, green and blue. It may be a bird, or this may be an animal, or this may be any truck like bus or train. This might be any kind of images. For these images, these features are selected like this. I think you know mean, median, mode, standard deviation, these are the part of statistics. Here, the images are converted into features. Here, the value red median, green median, and blue median. Actually, for this image, actually these are the pixel values. So, for these pixel values, median values are taken. Here we have red median, green median and blue median. Just what is the meaning of median, meaning of mode, meaning of standard deviation. These are the part of statistics. Already studied this statistics in max part of mathematics subjects. So here, these are the color features. This is RGB median. Similarly, RGBA, these are other two values. Here, standard deviation for blue, these are the, it is actually, these are the median values. It is a standard deviation for this blue. Only the standard deviation of blue is considered here. This RG and the BA, these are the some features with respect to these colors. Similarly, this image processing, various features exist. General features are color features, pixel features, shape features. These are the basic features considered the image So, consider these texture features, this entropy, tamura 0 and tamura 1, these are the texture features. First, you know, what is color feature and what is a texture feature. So, color feature means, based on the color property of image, whose color features are taken. Texture means some repeated pattern. Just for example, if you are seeing a sand in a beach, or water in a beach, or a roof in a house, these are the repeated pattern will appear. For processing this kind of images, the textual feature will be more suitable. For example, sand in a beach, all the sand will have the same pattern. Okay, here the color is considered as a pattern. Similarly, one photograph is taken. The photograph represents the top of the roof, part along those means. Consider some tiles are in the top of the house. All the tiles will have the same pattern. So, processing of this kind of image need texture processing. Color processing is not suitable in this case. Similarly, some situation, shape features that will give the more result in this image comparison. For example, identification of elephant and identification of tiger, identification of some bird like eagle. So here the shape plays the important role. So this kind of image need a shape feature for its recognition. Some implementations that need a combination of texture features and features, color features and the shape features, color features and texture features. These combination also produces a good result. So here some example images are taken. For this example images, red medium, green medium and blue medium, these values are represented, and RGB medium, and RG and BOH. Actually, these are calculated from one formula. Then it is a standard deviation of blue. Similarly, the textual features, entropy, tamura 0, tamura 1. So these are the sum of parameters in this textual features. So here these values are used for representing particular feature of the image. Next, the image recognition algorithm compares the image using these features. Actually, this feature, if you are considering individual image means, these features are one dimensional array. For recognition of the human face, minimum 40 features are recognized. Actually, the human face or compression that does not need 5 or 6 or 7 features. Minimum 40 features are extracted from human face or compression. Among these 40 features, at least 50% of the features are used for recognition of the particular image. Here, the features are represented by some values. Using these values only, the images are produced. Directly, if you are comparing the pixel by pixel of an image, the exact two identical image only, the comparing this should be matched. But the intensity changes means the image should not be compared. But by taking these future values, definitely an image processing algorithm identify similar images. Okay, here the images are represented by means of some features. So, after representing this image by means of feature or some ornaments or vector values, Next, the retrieval algorithm operate and extract the similar images. For example, the number of testing images, this input image, one image is giving us input, and the number of testing, totally 1000 images are available. Relevant images in the test set, that's why this 25 images, the similar images, 25 available in this test set, and this may retrieve 29 images. So, the actual 25 images are available, but the algorithm will retrieve the 29 images. In this 29 images, relevant images are 18 and irrelevant images are 20. Okay, now the precision we call these values are represented like this. Actually, a separate formula exists for computing this precision and the recall. These are two of the muscles used in retrieving the images. How many correct images are identified? And how many correct relevant images are identified? This is identified by means of the precision recall. So, use some graph is drawn. From this graph only, how many relevant images are obtained? Similar conclusion can be achieved for any kind of image retrieval algorithm. That's why I am telling here is that in this way only the images are processed. Okay. For example, it is algorithm way of giving the input image. Here, the dinosaur-like image is given as input. For this image, this red average, green average, and blue average, this value, average, another number average is median, so no problem. So, and then red, green, and blue, these values are taken. Next, this entropy value, for the input image, these values are taken by this algorithm. Next, actually it is the input image. So this input image, the value are compared with the image exist in the database. These are the images exist in the sub-database. So actually this image database, the images are represented by itself, its values. The features of this image and the input image are compared using the feature values. So, actually the subway means of standard deviation group and subway means of this average color, subway RGBI values, subway this texture entropy, subway texture camera view, subway camera and subway all these methods. So, these are the various search methods. This give the different outputs. Some methods can be combined. Some processing will be combined two or three methods. The accuracy can be improved. In this way only, the image processing algorithms are implemented. Here, it is by means of color features and the texture features, the image retrieval is taking like this. Next, you get another question, how to, what is the meaning of red mean? So, red mean means, so take the average value of this pixel. These are all the red pixel. So, so already I told about invariant future. If you are taking the face of a human, distance between the eye, the distance between the eye can change two pictures, two same person pictures. But correct to width ratio of eye, that should not change for big picture or small picture. So similarly, here also find a linear in future among the red, blue and green coordinate of two-dimensional representation. Here, red mean means take the pixel values and then take the mean value among all these pixels. So, that represents the red mean or red average. domain. These are found there in the pictures. Similarly, you know about the meaning of mean, mode, and the standard deviation. These are the statistical parameters. These parameters are used for recognizing the images. Here actually this one PAR exists. And for this PAR, red mean, green mean, and blue mean, some values are there. And RGB mean. So RGB means red, green, and blue. For these three values, a mean value are there. Actually, if the two same picture appear means, this mean value deviate slightly. Okay, if the much deviation occurs means, these two are considered as different pictures. If the moderate deviation appears means, more or less, the coincidence occur. So, in this way, the images are processed. So here at the precision and recall, these are calculated by means of some formula. By means of one graph, the output is displayed how much accuracy the images are processed and the others are relevant images are displayed like this. It is how image are represented and how these images are processed by means of future values for understanding the future values only. I saw these slides. Next, going to some filtering like that. Actually, it is digital image. Usually, the image is a digital image and also analog image. Actually, analog to digital conversion process that is required. The camera captures the image and the output of lens it is analog. The analog output is converted into a digital form. So, converting this analog into digital, you know the analog to digital conversion and the digital to analog conversion. So, any camera that generate only the analog outputs. So, this analog output, just we are having a camera in cell phone. The cell phone, the camera produces analog image. But in memory card, the image is to be stored. But memory card is able to store only the digital images. So here, analog to digital conversion process takes place. So slightly more about analog to digital conversion process. So the images stored as pixel. Camera. So this picture values are represented by means of its intensity level. So this intensity level converted into a digital value. So next slightly more about the conversion process. Actually, it is one person. The eye is taken separately from this image and it is enlarged. It is possible in this digital image processing. Slightly more than analog to digital conversion process. And it is by means of sampling only this analog signal is converted into digital signal. Why I am telling here is that if you are taking the cell phone camera, the camera will generate the analog output. The analog output is covered into digital form. Then only the image is to be processed in digital form. And also we can transfer the image from one cell phone to another cell phone in digital way. So it is the conversion process. Image system, sampling and quantization, next to digital storage, next to digital computer that processes this image. So this online plotter and the images displayed and recorded. Here analog to digital conversion process. That's why it is analog part, it is a digital part, in between this analog and digital part, sampling and the quantization, this process exists. So just in your slide you know about sampling of pixels. So it is essential to know how to process this grayscale images. Generally, the grayscale image from image level 0 to 255 that is taken. So these are 256 and the 256 images. So now, actually this 256 into 256 array, this image is stored. Here, the same image is stored by means of 64 into 64. That's why when compared with 256 intensity level, the 64 bit intensity level is slightly blurred. The image clarity is somewhat reduced. It is the way of representing world as a black and white image. Okay, it is a black and white image. Just to remember, when it is represented as a white pixel and black pixel represent, does not represent any number. That is the left and right portion of the one. Actually, it is not a grayscale image, it is a black and white image. So now it is an 8-bit image. So why here is it is an 8-bit image means for storing the individual pixel, 8 bits are required. These 8 bits are 0, 0, 0 and 1, 1, 1. So similarly this pixel. How many pixels are approximate to the for this entire image? It is one image. So take it is one pixel, the pixel of this bottom line, it is one pixel, it is another one pixel, it is 3 pixels in this one bottom pixel. And here it is another one pixel, and here it is another one pixel, black pixel. So that plane five pixels is present in the row. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 pixels is present in the column. So total number of pixels is 5 into 5, 25. The size of this image is 5 into 5, 25 pixel values are used to represent this image. Here, how to represent this tau value intensity and low value intensity? Here, tau value intensity, generally, for representing the black, 255 value is used. For representing the white, 0 value is used. By means of this intensity value only, those pixels are represented. Here, actually, it is one of black and white image. It is another image, 256 into 256. Actually, 256 rows and 256 columns and 256 levels. 256 levels means that represents the intensity of the pixel. So, 256 level means this pixel is more clear than 32 level pixel. So here it is a 32 level pixel. Now the intensity value is reduced. So size of this pixel is 256 into 256. It is a lower column. It is a level dependent. I think you know the meaning of 32. So 2 to power 2 it is a power, 2 to power 3 is 8. And 2 power 4 is 16. Similarly, for 32 level, 16, next is 32. So, totally, from SIBIT's flow, SIBIT's used for representing the scientific elements. It is the good is low in so usually if you are taking any work means take base case for the rising and the future and compare the various images using these features and variables in the images. So intensity level means reduced means the image passing algorithm process in a faster manner. So if the intensity level is raised, the error level means the takes time and no matter of the passing power is required. So insulin users go through this black and grayscale image that with the very low intensity level. Actually, it is difference between 256 level picture and 2-level picture. Actually, 2-level means it is a grayscale image. It is covering the level 256. It is a grayscale, it is not a grayscale image. 2-level means only zeros and ones. It is actually a binary image. Zeros and ones are only the person in this image. So 2-level. One level is 0, another level is 1. So it is a black and white image. It is for passing purpose, this take very low time for generating its outputs. Similarly, it is a color image. Color image means three arrays are required. One is red, green, and the blue. These are the three arrays. Every image is represented by using these three two-dimensional values. From this, actually here, these are the values. These are generally it's a pixel value, okay? So these pixel values are used in computing the mean variance standard deviation. These values are taken using these pixel values. Okay, these values are only being processed by means of image processing algorithm. Okay, it is a gray level image. A gray level image means the intensity level varies from 0 to 255. So it is a kind of processing. The color image is converted to a grayscale image. Various algorithms are available. Your photograph can be easily connected to this photograph. It is actually a binary image. Only zeros and ones, these are only used in this binary image. This image processing that needs passing of the signals. Manipulation of multi-dimensional signals. Image, otherwise photo, it is represented by f of xy. Right here, it is f of xy, that is a value. Okay, this value and x and y represent the coordinates, and f of xy represents the value on in that coordinate, in that x and y, in two-dimensional coordinate. If you are taking the video signal, in addition to this x and y, time is added as a part of the video. Just if you are taking the CT and MRI scanning, MRI images, x, y, z and the time, these are the values used for processing this MRI and the CT scan images. Just nowadays for bone related problem, doctor asking for this MRI scan or CT scan. It is for knowing the depth value of particular bone or particular joint. This depth value is easily shown by means of CT scan and MRI scan. also they use the jet dimension is added as a part of the image. The accuracy will be more. Okay, why this image processing is required? It is for image compression, image enhancement, restoration, reconstruction, analysis, detection, dimension, understanding, visualization. For all this image processing, I think you know nowadays every jewelry shop and the bank is carrying camera. 24 hours the camera recording consumes more requirement from the edge. By means of image processing algorithm, one can design the algorithm to record only the film is coming inside the particular room. Then only that will record, otherwise that should not record anything. So there is no movement in the room means the recording is not needed. If there is any change occur inside the room, means then it is this part captured by means of camera. Nowadays the camera operates like based on the movements. It is all by means of this image processing. Mainly for this only applications is such a kind of algorithms are required. Next, this image transform. Why this image transform is required in time domain representation and frequency domain representation? These are the different representation for image. This time domain representation, actually the image is processed what it was captured. In the frequency domain representation, it is done into some other form. Actually, this image transformation that generate another one base for this analysis, you can say actually image transform. It is original image. It is a Fourier transform. If the Fourier transform is applied on this image, this amplitude and phase, these two parameters are used in this Fourier transform. The image is converted into this another one form. Actually, after converting the image into Fourier transform, then the processing is applied on this transformed image. Actually, this frequency, it is a frequency domain representation. It is a time domain representation. Algorithm exists to process the image on this time domain representation. Similarly, this algorithm exists to process this Fourier transform the image. So, accuracy will be more as compared with the time domain representation, frequency domain representation give the more accuracy for the purpose only, not for all the images. For some kind of images, this frequency domain will give the more accuracy. For some kind of images, time domain analysis will give the more accuracy. Actually, this image enhancement, another kind of image enhancement is filtering. Actually, on the left side you are seeing one image. In this right side, only the edges of images are shown. It is called a high pass filter. If the image is subjected to high pass filtering, means already I told about the filtering. So, image is subjected to this high pass filtering, means these edges are easily affected. Actually, already I told about one Swamiji application. The camera captures the image, but capture only there is a change within the room. So, to capture the images based on the changes means, first the image are converted into subject. The image, actually the video capturing camera means, individual the video tape frames. Actually, 25 frames per second that forms the one movie. It is the general case. So, we are taking one frame among this video and convert that frame into type pass filter. Otherwise, type pass filtering is subjective on this image. Next, the outer edges are easily identified. So, next, if the safe recognition algorithm is applied after this type pass filtering, easily the human can be identified. Otherwise, if animal like cat or dog move inside the room means the human face is separated from dog and the animal movement. And here, no need to record dog movement and deaf cat movement within a room. So now, this type pass filtering algorithm used to avoid such a kind of mismatch between this human, animal, or any bird. So now this filtering algorithm plays important role to distinguish between various kinds of objects. So it is a type pass filtering. Type pass filtering means highest attribution component only be extracted from the image. Actually, the edges are the highest attribution component with the, in this images. These are only the extractors. Similarly, one image is available on this website, and the restored image means some improved image is present on this right side. Distorted image is having more number of noise. From this distorted image, this restored image is having less number of noise. So generally the same concept used in photo studio to renew of old photo into the new photo. It is by means of this image restoration technique. Sometimes camera misfocus but also generate this distorted images. These are eliminated by means of some image processing algorithm. I think you are able to distinguish between this left side and the right side image. So right side image clearly this is distorted image. The image is not clear. So it is called as a distorted image. So now this distorted image is converted into this original image by means of some image processing algorithm. Similarly, by means of camera misfocus, distortion will occur. So it is left side is original image, right side is by means of a focus, this distortion occur. This distortion, distorted image is converted into original image by means of some filtering algorithm. It is a distortion due to motion. It is this effect is also passed by means of lens. The original image can be obtained. It is distortion due to noise. Actual left side image does not have any noise, but right side image having more noise. This noise can be completely eliminated. So already I told about salt and the pepper noise. So similarly, various kinds of noises are there. So this noise is completely removed from the images by means of this image filtering algorithm. So this next to this image compression. So image compression that needs some signal processing concept. So f of x y is the input to this encoder. And the generate the g of xy, that is the compressed representation. G of xy decoder subjected to some decoding that generate the f dash of xy, not f of xy. Why it is represented as f dash of xy means the original image and regenerated image after compression should not be the same. Some displacement or some deviation occur between this original and the compressed image. So that is represented by f of xy, and another one is represented as f dash of that's right. Compressed and decompression. It is part of the image compression. So this all these images are amenable to this computer analysis. Computers work with numerical data rather than the pictorial data. Clearly know the computer works with the numbers, not on the picture. Next, the image is to convert the numerical form before passing by computer and comments. Next, the picture element or pixel, these pixels, we are not passing the pixels, we are passing only the numerical data or values. These values are processed and output is generated. Actually, this image processing that needs only the processing of this picture and that's why picture values are 0 to 255. Next, this f of xy, this is f of xy value. Actually, this value is somewhat different from intensity of the pixel. So, actually, the intensity value but subjected to custom conversion. The value only be represented as part of this. So, image processing that needs the processing of these values. It is a grayscale image. So, here one array is enough to represent this image. Now, concentrate on grouping. Actually, this, whenever we are studying about the image processing, filtering is a basic step in this image processing. So, left side image, it is some f of xy, right side image is g of xy. So, filtering operation is performed on this image. Actually, this right side image is carrying more clarity than this left side image because it is subjected to some filtering algorithm. It is this filtering is to improve the quality of the image. Just to see the bottom image. In this image, the outer edges are taken. Actually, it is a left side image. It is one table, on this table some objects are there. This filtering algorithm generates the outer boundaries of the images. So, here, left side, these boundaries are only are they represented. So it is for useful for image recognition task. Now previously saw an algorithm or filtering algorithm, actually this type of that extract only the output boundary of the image. So clearly know the difference between the spatial domain and the frequency domain. Okay. Spatial domain means f of xy it is spatial in nature, g of xy is also spatial in nature. Some operations are applied on the images. So this operation converts this f of xy into g of xy. Now one pixel value is converted into another pixel value and it is stored. In this frequency domain, f of xy is subjected to from transfer operation. That is PF Lutonavi. So whenever you are seeing this image processing operation, in the frequency domain, this f of xy is represented as a PF UV. Some operation is performed on this PF UV, it generates R TF UV. So R TF UV means it is subjected to some changes in frequency domain. That this operation R, that is and then inverse transform is performed. So this g of a and g of xy, these two are in the spatial representation. You need this t of uv, r of t of uv, these are in this frequency domain representation. So already we told that frequency domain is more accurate than the spatial domain. So the image calls in, makes the algorithm to process the image in the suspicion. Okay, some of the spatial domain methods. So it is a fine processing method. Fine processing method means just input pixel values are taken and the pixel value is marked. G of xy equal to D of f of xy. It is D is an operator on one pixel. For example, one pixel is available, but one is 5. That value is changed as 6. Just easily, the pixel value is incremented by 1. So automatically the intensity value 5 is marked as intensity value 6. So the conversion operation P that operate on the single pixel. Some operation is applied on the single pixel. So now, the image is somewhat distorted. Okay, well, so it is a simple operation applied on the spatial domain. Similarly, mass processing method, here the group of pixels are taken and those are converted into another form. Instead of considering the single pixel, here only the single pixel value is converted into some other form. For example, x equal to x plus 1 or x equal to x plus 5. X is a pixel. The pixel value is incremented by 5 by means of x equal to x plus 5. Individual pixel are only considered means that is called as fine processing. Or mass processing method means group of pixels are considered, that is called as a mass processing method. Generally, the mass size may be 3 by 3 or 5 by 5. So, in this way, the masks are taken and processed for detail. Usually, the masks are taken as R number 3 by 3, 5 by 5, 7 by 7. In this way, only the masks are taken. But it is not wrong to choose the mask as a 4 by 4 or 6 by 6. In this way also the mask can be taken, but usually the mask value are always odd. So there some group of pixel means that is called as mask processing methods. It is a fine processing method. Convert a given pixel value to any pixel value based on some predefined definition. It is called as fine processing methods. In this fine processing methods, some operations are done on the pixels. Here, negative. Image negative are easily generated. For example, here all black value is converted into white value. All white value is converted into black value. So it is called as an image negative. So here just you see these two pictures. Just these two pictures are negative to one another. So based on this intensity level, background black is converted to background white. And black value is converted into white value. So if we generate the image like this, means it is an image negative. Next one is this contrast stretching. So contrast stretching means, actually here it is a one image. Next this image is converted into one image that is clearer than this image. Now, how to generate the contrast stretching? Just take this image. This image is subjected to some statistical operation. For example, if we take some 5 value 3 by 3 pixel and find the average of this pixel, now the image like this will be generated. It is by means of contrast stretching. So similarly, this thresholding, okay, this thresholding operation considers the image only beyond a particular level of pixel. So here it is one grayscale image, it is one black and white image. Now consider the pixels above some value. For example, it is 0, highest value is 255. You consider the pixel 250, above the value of 250. So remaining pixels are represented as 0. So represent only the values by above 250 means from this picture, so this picture will be generated. Actually, this it is another image by means of thresholding technique. The image is represented like this. So it is by means of histogram equalization. So it is one image. If the histogram is another concept. So by means of histogram equalization technique, this image is converted into clear image. These are the various point processing methods. So point processing method and area processing method, both are used to improve the quality of images. Area shape and size. Area size is determined by the mass size. Just mass size is important parameter. Area shape is typically defined using vector or mass scale. Just it is a image. Usually the origin is top left corner. It is the origin of screen. Any screen top left corner is the origin of the screen. It is 3x3 neighborhood of x and y. These are, it is a pixel value means. It is a 3x3 neighborhood of this pixel. So it is x and y. So a spatial domain, it is only a spatial domain representation. So now it is a mask, linear combination of pixel value, weight pixel value and ARM together. So it is one mask. This mask is operated on this pixel. For example, W1, W2, W3, W4, W5, W6, W. It is one 3x3 mask. This mask is operated on this image. It is one full image. If this mask is operated on this image, means the final quality of image is changed. How to operate this mask on this image means, so perform some arithmetic operation with respect to the pixel value and the value stored in this mask. So that arithmetic generates some result using the result only the image be represented. So from the processing of the mask in the spatial domain, the low pass filter, high pass filter and band pass filter, similarly various filter algorithms are generated. So it is one example. Actually this it is one image, it is one mask. The image is modified because this mask operates on this image. So this image is modified. Modified, it is a modified image data. So how to apply the mask on this image? Just I am telling by means of a simple example. Just if you are writing one objective question, means the correcting this answer is a very easy process. You, for example, one question is available. Here A, B, C, D, these are the three options. One person can pick either A or B or C. Anyone of these answers should be just take by means of pen or pencil. So to find the correct answer for this answer, just you place one polythene sheet, and with the polythene sheet, correct answers. What are the correct answers exist? That only displayed after placing the polythene paper on the answer sheet. You see asking to count the total number of correct answers by means of this MOS. Okay. So similarly, W1, W2, W4, W2, it is your MOS. This MOS is moved along the image from left to right in the orientation of top to bottom. Then new pixel values marked. Some operation is applied on this MOS from the image. For example, W1 into 10 plus W2 into 5, W3 into 3, W4 into 4, W5 into 6, plus W6 into 1. So similar operation is applied between the mask and the image. Now, one pixel value that is replaced by the resultant computation. What we have here, 9 multiplication and the 9 additions are 9 multiplication, 9 additions are performed. The resultant value is only 1. So that values replaced the particular pixel. For example, this 0.5 here exists. After performing this mask operation on the image, some value 8 is generated. This 8 value retrieved based on the values of W1 to W9. So in this way, the image data is modified. These two are the linear correlation and convolution. These are the linear operation performed on the image. So correlation, the correlation, the filtered image is generated as the center of mass. This is every pixel in the input image. So it is center of the mask received to every pixel. Okay, the center based on the center of mask, the values generated means it is called as correlation. For example, it is one image input image, it is a mask. So this mask is operated on this image using this center of mask. So now these values are replaced. So if this is called as correlation. And in the pixel goes to the boundary. You saw the pixels goes to the boundaries are handled by adding the zeros. So we add zeros, two vertical zeros and two horizontal zeros, these are the some main operations to handle the boundaries of the pixel. So in this way the correlation is performed. Actually, this is a moving mass on the image. It is one moment. Now, one value is operated, means that is replaced by the previous value. Now, another movement. So, another value is operated and that value is represented. So, it is finally, similarly, all the values are replaced. So, it is the correlation. And the normalized correlation is also generated. It is a mask and it is your own image. And this normalized, this mask operate on this image means this image generated like this. And next to convolution, same as correlation, except the mask is split to both conjointly and vertically. In this correlation, only the pixel replacement with respect to center of the mask. In this convolution, the pixel replacement with respect to top left of the mask, or middle top of the mask, or top right of the mask. If operation changes like this, means that is called a convolution. And the mask is moved from it is one image, it is one mask. Operate this image with respect to the mask, so some values are generated. So it is a convolution. So here it is a downward type, so it is a mask, it is an image, this it is a padding of this. Now this mask is operated by this image, it is generate the pixels like this. So in this way the convolution algorithm operate on the image. So generally the masks are represented by means of class 2 weights or 1 2 weights. Now based on the placing of values, various kinds of filters are generated. It is an example for such a filter, 1 by 9 into 1 1 1. It is a mask, 1 by 16 into 1 2 1. It is another mask. So smoothing and averaging of pixel, smoothing using averaging device. Replace is the average of its neighbor. So here every pixel is replaced by means of average of its neighbor. So now the smooth image can be obtained. Now it is image, it is image, it is mask. This mask is applied on its image, this generates the new image. Now this smoothing is generated. So it is more suitable for the image like this. Noise and blurring or loss of detail. The image is contains noise or blurring of objects in this image. So it generates the image to its end quality. So it is a Gaussian mask. Replace each pixel by weighted average of its meter. So every pixel replaced by means weighted average of meter means the image is generated like this. It is for smoothing, performing this smoothing average. Now this bed is represented towards time quality for various application of mask on this image. Now R-racing measures Gaussian smoothing. So if the average value applied on this image means the output is generated like this. If Gaussian filter is applied on this image means the output image is generated like this. These are the properties of Gaussian noise. It is example for convolution. So now two images, 2D convolution and 1D filters. So these are the various operations that are applied on this mask and images. Actually, the image sharpening, it is also achieved. Here, already we saw the mask, but here, the values of the mask are -1, -1, -2. Here -2, 0, -1, -1, -2. If this mask is applied on this input image, the the image quality is improved to its next level. So it is called as a sharpening. So this filter, actually already such a kind of filters are designed and exist in S algorithm. So it is called as a sharpening filter. If represent the filter values are assigned like this means, it is called the image sharpening. Just if it is an input image, if the mask is applied on this input image means, the image quality is somewhat improved. So it is sharpening of the image. Just to improve the quality of image to reach the next level, it is the sharpening of the image. So in this way the filtering algorithm, I think you know how the filtering algorithm operate on particular image. Just this value, the mask value, are multiplied with the pixel value in order to generate the new pixel value.
Magesh sir, still 15 more minutes. We will wind up around 12:30.
12:30.
Still 15 minutes. Padana nimisha irukku.
Okay. In this way, the image processing algorithms is applied on the particular image. So, this image quality is somewhat low, but this image quality is somewhat high because of applying this mask on this image. Actually, this 1/9 into this mask, it is applied on this image, and the replacement is like this. Now the image quality is improved. This right hand side image. So in this way the filtering algorithms work for a particular image. So because this I'm able to cover only the few portion, if this image processing is very vast, not able to cover all the topics under this one session. I think we know how to take the feature of the image and how these features can be applied for image retrieval and how to apply the filtering algorithm and the image to improve the quality of image or to extract the boundaries of the image and to remove the noises from the image. So in this way the filtering algorithms are applied on the image. To get a fine detailed quantity of the images. So nowadays already I told about three kinds of image processing is possible. One is low level, middle level and high level. Nowadays image processing algorithm going towards the high level processing algorithm, and middle level processing is also exists. According to my knowledge, low-level processing algorithm that was finished to its maximum level. But high-level and middle-level image processing algorithm is low-level for improving the quality of images. If you want to do any work on this image processing algorithm, this high-level processing again the demanding area. For the purpose, one of the tool, my next another question generally arises, how to take the picture of the image. Actually, the picture of is taken by means of the various tools. One is MATLAB. By means of MATLAB, we can take the picture of tools. Another tool, image ramager, that is one of the tools that exists to take the picture of the images. Just to install IMG, RUM, MAG, this image ramager, that is one of the software. That software is having, I think, more than
just to put it in the chat box so that the participants can
okay, thank you. Just if you want to work on image processing means use MATLAB, Python or Ramager. Okay, thank you. Inquiries?
Sir, type that software name in the chat box, sir.
Software name, image Ramager.
Chat box, sir, chat box. Nearby to people, 17, nearby to Nikon, sir. People 17, nearby to that Nikon, 12:20 p.m. சென்டர் சென்டர் ஒன் ஐக்கான், மேலே ஒரு சென்டரில் ஒரு ஐக்கான் இருந்தாங்க, 12:20 PM பக்கத்தில் மேலே. மேலே மேலே அங்கே பாருங்க, மேலே 12:20 PM போட்டிருப்பாங்க. ஆ அது அதான் ரைட். ஓகே கீழே சேட் பாக்ஸ் கீழே போட்டுருங்க, கீழே கீழே.
Yes, it is one of the tool, more than 200 pages exist in this tool. You can take and process the images using this tool, and various that nowadays, so more than 5,000 pictures can be taken for the images. These are all processed. But any queries?
Sir, is it possible to share PPT, sir, your PPT? Whether it is available in Drive or your PPT presentation, sir?
Okay, thank you.
Sir, is it possible to share your PPT, sir? Whether it is in a Drive link or whether you are going to...
No,
sir. Okay. So, the PPT vandhe idhila Drive la potringala illa eppadi?
Send pannira.
Okay, right. Okay, sir. Professor Mahesh from CSE department. He did his PhD in PhD Tech, Anna University. He finished his PhD, completed his PhD in 2016. Professor Sir has more practical experience in image processing. He usually preferred to give practical assignments to his students. He trained his students in both in proprietary software like MATLAB and open source software like Python, Scilab in processing image and video processing. Participants, do you have any doubts in this or queries related to this presentation? Kindly ask. Any participant want to give feedback related to this presentation? Any participant? Professor Kavita, Gajendran sir, any feedback? Professor Kavita? Okay, very nice session, sir. Okay, right.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Participants, afternoon session, you come back around 2:30, we will discuss the files add with your Drive files add with you. I'm going to give you the practical a demonstration of how to you process still images using Python, and I'm going to share you the video processing programs using Python. Okay, so the quiz number 3 related to the still image processing using Python, and quiz number 4 is related to the video processing using Python. Okay, so come back at 2:30, join exactly at 2:30 PM so that we can discuss all those programs add to your to you. Okay, so the files add to you in the forenoon session related to the still image processing file programs. In the afternoon session, I am going to share you the video processing programs also. So come back exactly at 2:30 PM so that we can practice all the programs related to the still image processing and video processing. Thank you. Sir, thank you, sir.
Okay,
thank you.